jump on though. Yeah. Oh yeah. So, we have a lot of stuff today. Ah, yeah. Isn't that nice? Just spam with caps lock, no problem. Trying to put out really sweet maybe. Some more people coming in there. Is the sound okay? Is the picture? I think it's okay. Yeah, it's going nice today. As you see, I just built together this this frame. It was actually an okay one. It was probably a cheap one, but I think it will do the work, do the job. So I already put it together because it would probably be really boring to look at. So yeah, it's not a, as you can see, I have six more of them. No, five more of them over here. So I'm going to the other ones down in the basement, the wood ones, I'm going to put inside of this. So I actually got, yeah, you can probably see one of them behind me. I got like, you see this kind of frames, I got like four of those. So what are those like? Asus cards, yeah, it's 1070s. So this was one of the, so I got eight of them today. And this is actually my first Nvidia build, like my own Nvidia build. So that can be quite fun. And I also got these three cards over here today. This is the Zotac, also can, I haven't actually opened this yet and looked at them. It's 1070, 8GB too. We do a little unboxing then. Yeah, yeah, it's like just plug and play almost. So I've seen a lot of people working with them, and yeah, you probably want to see this. Working with them, and of course I have the only Nvidia card I had so far was this 1050 Ti actually over there. Let me see. We look at this good stuff. So this is the Zotac card. Let me see it. There. This camera is not really good, but yeah, you can see it. Nice and shiny. This can be fun. It's actually starting to get real late there now. I think it's about almost 12, like 11:30 p.m. now. Yeah, I think that's a good card actually. Too bad I only got three of them. I would hope I got like eight of those too, but that's okay. I'm probably gonna use those cards in my own gaming computer maybe. My girlfriend's gaming computer is not that good, so it can be an upgrade maybe. We'll see. Or I just put them in a rig and just let them work instead. It's time to try some Nvidia on gaming instead of the AMD 580 cards that I already have in it. So as I said, I got a lot of stuff today. I got three of these boards. The C270 boards. So with the extra expansion for the riser, and also 8GB of RAM in every in all of them. I'm not sure what kind of processors that's on them yet. Probably the cheap ones, but and, what more do we, yeah, and I got about 10 power supplies, I think. most of them are 750s, I think, actually all of them, but maybe one 6, yeah, one EVGA 650 over here, but, so I have a lot of spare parts now, a lot to play around with, so I was thinking of at least putting this machine together today, and try testing it a little. First, I just want to prepare the word that I'm live and see if there's someone. Not that it's not nice to just have you timed out, but I see if there's someone more left to come into the stream before we really start building. If not, it's just you and me today. I posted a picture on my Discord. Ah, nice! Thank you! Thank you for the retweet and all the love today when I was in my earlier post today. I actually got a lot of retweets and yeah, and likes and stuff like that. That's always fun. Yeah. A few places. Now we're good to go. I think I'm going to So, how's your day today? How's it going with the RX 570 rig you got? Is it still not good? You can see actually the rig that's running in the background. That's of course 470 cars. They are running at 30.2 now. I thought I got them stable at around 30.5, but it started to give me some rejected chairs today, so I turned down the clock a little and it seems stable now. That thing is giving me a headache. Look. What kind of memory was on the cards? I don't remember. Let's see. This is 8x10, 7. Tag a few people and then there you go. Of course I have to tag you too, right, Panda? Oops, no RGB. Ah. Oh yeah. The Hynix. Yeah. Okay, two of the cards are Hynix. Yeah, because I actually have... I think I have almost 60 cards now. That's Hynix memory and... They are actually performing quite well. They are easy to just copy the 1500 steps and maybe do some tweaking on the core clocks. So I have them running at about 30. Actually the 570s I got up to 31 I think. And the other is 580s and they are a little over 30. So thing happens. Left on the left now. Ah, yes. Actually, I haven't looked at it today. Almost like looking at it, yeah, almost every day, but actually today I haven't looked. Actually, mining ETC right now, in all my rigs. Not quite sure what I'm going. Maybe I put this on green, I'm not sure yet. Because it's like, I think difficulty is still up. I think it will soon drop. So almost with every new coins, the first month or so, it's really up and then it starts falling off when, you know, the people that just jumping on it for getting the quick bucks the first day, and then they just doesn't care anymore. And beam or green right now, almost got to the rear. I was actually maybe thinking about testing beam too, I haven't tested that yet. I also looked at, of course, Raven or like Suka or something like that, but I have a few green because that's the funny part. My 24 RX 470s was running on green from day one and maybe a week or so. And I actually mine with 24 cards, I mine less green than I will do on these cards together, I think, actually. So, AMD is not good for the green mining. But for the first day it was okay. Yeah, I know it's actually, yeah, I bought some cards around Christmas, I think. But now I feel like, yeah. It's like really fun when you get the new cards. It's like Christmas all over again. I'm just going to put the link on one of my Norwegian sites for the mining community. Yeah. It's like an addiction almost. Really an addiction actually. Like I say, it's a lot of people say like, yeah, well, why are you still mining? It's not profitable and blah blah blah. But for me it's like an, yeah, it's like a hobby actually. So, hey, the technicals! Welcome to my stream. I think that's the first time I see you here actually. Yeah, I'm just soon we'll start to put together this rig and I got a lot of stuff today, as you probably see earlier today. So I got, I think, three motherboards with CPUs and memories, and I get 10 power supplies, I think, and yeah, actually 10 frames, and one of them was with 8 cards, and I have 3 of these cards over here, so I don't get around Twitch much anymore, unless I'm watching Twitch. yeah, it's been, you don't get around Twitch. Twitch is okay. I was actually thinking about start to stream more maybe to YouTube, but I like the Twitch aspect actually. So I think it's better for me to just download the videos and then probably put them on YouTube, but I haven't had quite the time to do it yet, so. Okay, then we can soon start, just have to the Sparrow streaming platform, hands down. Yeah, it is. Yeah, I know. I've seen a lot of people like, yeah, I got quite big on YouTube, and then they try the same on Twitch, and yeah, they get, of course, quite a bit of followers, but not as much. And I think, like, yeah, like for me, or yeah, for both of you also, in the like mining and hardware and stuff, I don't think maybe Twitch is the best place, because more about gaming. Most of people that's on Twitch is more about gaming. But yeah, I actually think about that sometimes also. Yeah, it's hard. And as I say, I don't do it for like the big fame or anything. I just think it's fun. It's like I would do this without streaming also, but more fun when you can interact with other people that has the same, yeah, like same interest as you. Like, if I go out to the neighbors around there, I don't think anyone of them have even heard of like a mining rig, so it's not that, yeah, it's nice to be a part of the community. Thanks for the follow, appreciate it. 200 followers now, maybe I have to do something crazy when I get 100 followers. Okay. Yeah. Then I think we are ready. Let's see. I was just publishing on one of my Norwegian Facebook groups, and it took some time because I forgot to. I was too occupied with you two guys. I just, yeah, so, and I see, it's the same, I see, like, yeah, the big, like, yeah, take, like, Bixby Twipping, or, yeah, I see, like, other people also, it's going, yeah, I think, yes, like, Carter started streaming on Twitch more, like, a year ago or something, and I see it. Like the views is way down on Twitch. If he starts like a YouTube stream nowadays, he got a few 200-400 views, and there are people in there, but on Twitch it's maybe like maybe 100 in a good day. Yeah, I was actually wondering about the mic, because I didn't have quite a good spot to put it today. I'm trying like this new setup here with an extra table and so. Lower the music. Yeah, no problem. That's why you are here, so you can tell me when I screw up, you know. It was a little too loud. Yeah, is that okay? Oh, I can hear it, and I don't think it's too loud. Yeah, maybe we try put this crazy bastard together. Just have to like organize a little so I don't like drop anything. Ah, that's good. I think we just put the cards over there for now. So don't like accidentally drop them on the floor. That wouldn't be nice. Okay. As I said earlier, if I bought some of yours, yeah, how's it going with the New Year's sale on GPUs? You get them sold, or? Yeah, on Twitter, yeah, it was actually, I think it was really nice price on your GPUs actually, but for me it would probably be a problem. I would have bought some of you if I wasn't living in Norway. 1080 is on 29 minutes. I think. Hey! Carter! Bit ripping. How's it going tonight? No, today it will be your place. It's night time here now. I'm going to work tomorrow, so I was actually planning on starting this stream earlier today, but yeah, you know, kids and stuff. So I couldn't just leave this for today, then I would have gone mad. I just had to put this together today. Shipping and customs probably, yeah, it hurts. Shipping isn't probably that bad, but the custom, of course, if I buy something from United States or something like that, you could always put it like a gift or just put the value really low, but because I have to pay like the taxes from of the value of them. Yeah, a bit organizing myself, been slammed with work, like the conference is being gone. Yeah, how was the trip actually? Don't know if I asked you yesterday. What's the plan on the stream today? Some new juicy stuff? Yeah, this doesn't seem to fit all that well. Royal Caribbean, 7 day symphony disease, yeah. I was on a Royal Caribbean cruise last year. I don't remember the name of the boat though, but I don't remember, but it was really nice. It was this kind of party cruise, so it was like DJs playing all night, and I was in Spain and Ibiza, so it was actually really fun. But I would really be nice to take, like, of course, more normal cruise sometime with the kids when they get a little older. The casino is always fun. I think actually I have like $100 in my nightstand or something from last time I was on the cruise and in the casino. That was the only thing I brought with me home, and of course you can't like spend dollars in the shop over here, so kind of annoying. You see, this is actually just like three pieces of like some plastic. It doesn't line quite up as it should. Yeah, it's probably better. Okay frame, but I wouldn't paid too much for these frames. I got them almost for free, so it's okay, but you can probably build them cheaper yourself, I would think. Like these frames. No, I put the cards in them. Put them over here. Put them over here. Is the Asus 270? Yeah, it's the 270. It's the 270. 270A. I think you get the A or maybe H, I think. Or some other types of them. This is the A, yeah. made about 2,200 in casino. So that was a bonus. Blackjack and rest on craps. That's nice. I think I lost more than I won last time. Yeah, Red Panda Cruise is actually really fun. It's not just old people there now. I think it's actually, I think they like marketing a lot to try to get younger people to go on the cruises. Not, was before it was more like 60 plus, I think. Okay, actually it's time to fire this board up soon. We should put the power supplies first before we start on the cards. And we have to move the mic again, so excuse me people for ruining your ears right now. This one, yeah. So as I said earlier, I think I got about 750 Corsairs today, almost. No, 8 of those and 2 or 3 VPA, I think. So I should have a lot of power supplies to play around with nowadays. It's with every hardware, you can't get enough. Never enough. Just turn this around. A lot of peace use, man. Yeah, it was actually, I thought I would only get like, yeah, 2 in each frame or something, and the one frame had 4 750s in it. I think they had like 8 1080 cards in that frame earlier. Yeah, it's, as I was actually saying earlier, it's like people are like, yeah, it's not profitable and all of that. I think I have about, yeah, 70 plus cards now, and it's like, yeah, I don't make money on them now. It's like, of course I make coins on them, but I'm not selling it either for now. I'm just holding it, just take the expenses of the power and see where it goes. And for me it's like kind of a hobby. I always enjoyed like building computers and stuff, and earlier I was also a lot into cars and restoring old cars and no cars, and that also costs a really lot of money. So it's like, if you're going to do anything and it's a hobby, it costs money. If you are building mining rigs, or if you are fixing cars, or like building houses for that matter, but it costs money, everything. As long as you enjoy it, maybe you can make some money on it on the way. Yeah, it's expensive hobbies that's the fun hobbies, isn't it? I'm actually working on a car also right now. It's an old English car. It's an Austin A30. It's a 1953 model. It's like, there's not a lot of them because it's, what do you say, it's not like a, it was not a, like a popular car back in the days. It was like a cheap, every man in the street car. A lot of them got, yeah, just smashed when I was
when they were old, so
that's actually kind of fun car.
Yeah,
Ford is one of my favorites actually. I actually built a Ford Granada. How do you say it in English? Granada or something like that. And I built it with a big engine and stuff, so I actually have that car standing in the garage. I think that car probably cost me at least the same amount I used on mining rigs now. One parking spot, yeah. I have like a lot of parking spots around my house, I think. Probably fit 100 cars or so. Yeah. Thanks for stopping by. Enjoy your dinner. So did you manage to see a lot of places when you was on the cruise, Carter? Probably stopped a lot. The ship. We just use the grill for these ones. So as I said, this is actually my first like real NVIDIA build. So really really glad I got these cards today. Was it the gigabyte version on the 570 cards Panda we had with the Hynix memory? Or was it? I'm looking on. Yeah, you're looking for cards. Yeah, as I said, it's an addiction. We are like hash. No, what do you call it? Mega hash junkies. Digital kind of junkies. Yeah, gigabyte 570s with Hynix. 4 or 8 gigabyte? Was it 4? I don't have the boxes for it here, but yeah, actually I have one of the boxes. This is the, no, that's the Auris, yeah. Auris Gigabyte. This is the one that I got. I think I have 8 of these cards with the 4 gigabyte. I can actually you can take a quick look at and on the screen over there. Just see, I think it's this one, yeah. I'll show you my hashes on the 570 cards. Just go to the girl on my screen. Whoa. Let me see. I think it's, no, this is the wrong farm. It's this farm, yeah. So this is my 570 gigabytes. So 30.95. That's actually on ETC. If I run like, yeah, I was mining Ella and Ubik, I think. No, not Ubik, but Ella and Ethereum, I think. Then it actually goes around 31.02 or something. Yeah, nice girl. So as you can see, they've been running stable for a long time now, without any issues. And I have them overclocked at 2150 actually, and 900 on the undervoltage. As you can see, I had to put up the
DPM to 6. I have 1150 on the core on them. And I think they only have the 1500 straps copied, I think. I don't think I've done anything more with them. Yeah, as I said before, I couldn't run them on more than 2100, but suddenly I just tried it and one day it worked. So because I was struggling at over 2100 before, but as you can see, if I put the voltage down more and stuff like that, I don't think they will run 2150. But yeah, the temps are okay. It's quite cold here now. I think it's about it's not the worst day today, but -5 like Celsius I think today. Also see, I think this is the 580 gigabyte. Yeah, actually got a few reactive shares over there, so they are actually running like 30.9 also. I think they only at 2100. Yeah, so you can see they draw a little bit extra of power on these settings, but power cost on the place where these rigs are is really cheap, so power isn't a big issue on those car machines. So then we put this down for now, and we can just have like the Matrix style in the background again, Matrix mining style. Maybe we can have this picture up for a while so you can see more what I'm doing. So we got the motherboard in, and I screwed in these two power supplies. This is one EVGA 750 and one Corsair 750, and we can probably start with the cards and the risers. Of course I could like screw the risers to the frame, but I don't like doing that because the first thing that's failing is the risers every time, so I don't want to mess with taking out four screws every time I have to change a riser, because probably know how it is. Risers is the main problem when building a rig, I think. At least it's the first thing that fails. Yeah, just screwing the GPU at in the frame. That's good enough. And it's easy to change out the risers if there should be any problems with them. Goodbye. Down on the floor. This is actually the version 6, I think. No, version 7. This was the ones that come with the other rig, because these cards, Asus cards over here, they were in another rig when I got them today, already rig that was already built, but I teared it apart and wanted to build it in this frame instead. Because it's they are really nice, these frames. They are homemade and they are like really rough, but you can probably throw them down the stairs without problem, not with cards in though, but I wanted to have like more cleaner look on them, at least when they are white cards, white frame. I think that will look awesome. Just have one more racer somewhere. Well, I should have 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Where did the last one go? I had 8 before. You found it. Yeah, of course, down here. White on white, yeah. I think the motherboard has the cool RGB, so it would be nice. I'm actually planning on putting one of these motherboards I got today in my wife's gaming machine and take one 1070 and put in there, because her machine is starting to get really old. Yeah, RGB is always good, isn't it? Yeah, me too. I like RGB. So this card already have the M.2 slot with the riser card, expansion card already plugged into it. I didn't mess with that after I took it out from the other machine. Not too bad. Don't think it would fit too well if I had to screw them in. So as I said, this is like cheap frame anyway, so measurements aren't probably that good. It will do the job, I think. It would be a really tight fit if I had screwed the risers to the frame. And the card would struggle to get in there, I think. So how is... Actually, the guy I was buying this of today, he had, I think he had like 8, like, S9s, like the Antminer S9 with the power supplies, and I told him that if he want I could take them off his hand so he doesn't have to like have them just collecting dust. Not that I'm a big fan of ASIC though, but if I got them for free it would be okay. No, he wasn't running them, they were just standing there and collecting dust. It was a little sad somehow. But that's how I like the ASIC collecting dust. That's the best way of the... That's the best thing they can do, I think. Of course, you can't like ignore them. They will always be there, so... Yeah, I told them they would be like nice, like what you call it, door stops or something like that. Don't know actually what an S9 could do like a day if you like had no power cost on it. Didn't probably do too well anyway. Yeah, I think so. I never had an ASIC and I don't ever think I'm going to buy one. As I said, if I got one for free, I would probably just have it standing there and do its work, but I didn't want to pay money for it. As I said, I have the opportunity to running with almost no power cost at all, so may be profitable to mine with them in that place, but really spend the money on GPUs instead. It's much more fun and they don't make that much noise either. That's the other part with the ASIC, make too much noise.
Yeah, same, same. Of course, the yeah, maybe we can get a few bucks for the power supplies, maybe. I don't know what power supplies goes for nowadays, but that's probably more worth than the miner itself. Of course, people always trying to put them on eBay or stuff like that for crazy amount of money, but it's the same actually with GPUs in Norway. People are trying to get way too much money for them. Because a lot of people was thinking they will be millionaires last year and bought of course, I bought a lot of GPUs as well last year, but I didn't like bought a lot of GPUs and was like, okay, next week it's not profitable, then I just sell them. Because as I said, I think this is fun to do. And everything that's fun to do costs money, so. But maybe sometime I can earn them back on this hobby, at least. Actually not too bad with the space between the cards on this. Probably have a little more space between them if I was building this frame myself, but it seems okay. And I think, like, as I understand, this Nvidia cards are probably running up maybe cooler than it does, doesn't it? Just have some crazy RGB lighting here now and then it would look awesome. It's actually maybe put this in my living room actually. My wife would probably kill me, but that's okay. Almost a showpiece. And with the and it's also have the white on the motherboard, and this is, it wasn't like planned like that, but it's almost like coming together as a white theme. Showpiece, yeah. Oh, that was the last card. I think I will only fire it with one card first. And get Windows up and running. I think I want to try Windows on this. I run Hive OS on all my machines, but I think I want to like have Windows on this one today just for testing and testing different miners and stuff like that. Yeah, just white LEDs. Yeah, I think I have some RGBs over here that I can. I think I have small, like, it's only the corner pieces left because I used like the long ones in the kit. These ones could actually go like maybe on the side or something here, light it up. Okay, then we have to put in some cables. More of this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and I have to put in 2, so I should have at least one more somewhere. Yeah, we have it. Yeah, I know, I actually used this multi-miner a lot. It was actually a few weeks back I started on coding a GUI for it, for the multi-miner. But it was kind of coming together. And then my machine got hacked, so I just wiped it, and I actually forgot to copy out the files for the source codes that I was making, so I haven't had time to like start it on it again. Mine beam green
Read Miner is just updated a new version today.
Yeah, I also heard, is it like, no, B Miner or something? It should have quite good hashes on Grin. Wasn't it B Miner?
Yeah, I think so.
But they don't support like AMD cards yet, they only support Nvidia cards on Grin, I think. On Beam, I think they support like both cards. G Miner, I'm not sure if I tested that yet. I know I tested some, yeah, B Miner and Grin Miner. Yeah, G Miner. I was told I should get about. Was it, it's 4.8 is it GPS or what you call it on Grin, these cards. Maybe some more if you overclock them more, I don't know. Okay, last riser cable. And then we can start putting in some power cables. It was actually quite nice setup on the cameras and stuff today. Wasn't too bad. Because earlier I had everything on the this table over here, but everything was like, didn't have place to work. I had to move stuff around all the time. Okay, it looks good. Thank you. Of course, this camera, yeah, the one over there. Isn't the greatest camera, but it's actually one over there is actually much better, but it's okay. Okay, so I'm actually wonder how this rig is to like lift around now that's full of cards and everything. It's actually not too bad. I was actually afraid it would be wobbly and stuff like that because it was like, yeah, as I said, not the most well-built frame, but actually it's quite nice. Let's turn it around and start putting in the power cables. Oh, it's starting to get heavy now. Well, as I said, these cards, no, these power supplies was already in the rig that had these cards in them, so should only be like plug and play. I shouldn't need to plug in some other cables to this. I think they had just, yeah, they just jumpered, if you can see, but it's like small cable here, they just jumpered the power supply to get it starting. I actually kind of like this frame more and more when I'm working on it now. So then we have like 4 PCIs and 4 SATAs on this one. We should have the same on this one, or we have here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 actually, but the last one is probably for the CPU, yeah. So try to plug in the CPU, try to make the cables as clean as possible. Looking like I'm trying to like do some cable management, not just making spaghetti of everything. At least if I'm going to put this in my living room. I have the other rigs down in the basement, and they are actually heating the house really good now in the winter. So then we start putting in the SATA connectors. As always, I am only using like two SATAs on one cable, not all three of them. Just to be sure. Yeah, I think so. Probably. She will probably say no. It hasn't, it's like she hasn't like kicked out my big speakers yet, but I think they will go soon. And suddenly the wife was in the chat and I actually think she's gone to bed. She's probably asleep maybe. Okay. Come on in there. In there you go. Ah, like this. Okay, and then we have like four of those. It's like I'm going to change either this EVGA or this Corsair out, I think, later with like a power supply that is the same, just because of my craziness. So, I was actually seeing the video you had on your friend's like enclosed mining rig the other day. Was it yesterday maybe? That didn't look too good. I will get an open frame instead, I think. So, because you move the cards in it or to make it some better. It doesn't burn them up. Yeah, it was brutal. I think actually when I saw when you started turning the cards around or something, told him that you should go, yeah, he doesn't want to. But the third card, because I think he was putting it up in the top of the base in the top for the, yeah, for the CD drives and stuff like that. Isn't that right? We are remember wrong. I move the third card to the optical. Yeah, in the top. I would actually try mount it like, yeah, like, ah, damn it, have a card, yeah. Like this instead in the base below, I think. But only, yeah, you maybe have the fans over there, so maybe that's not good. Then use TiVo-S and lower the wattage. Yeah. Yeah, it was probably much better just to move it somewhere, another place in the case. So, yeah, HiveOS is actually a really nice program, I think, like for the mining stuff. The front fans, yeah, will only hit it. Yeah, I actually remember it now when you. The only thing that the heat is always, you know, rising up. So, of course, if you have like the fan on the top that's dragging the heat out, it will probably be fine. Okay, so, this one was actually kind of loose. Check all the screws. It's probably in there. Yeah. Yep. Yep. Yeah, as long as you can move quite a bit of air in there, it will probably be okay. But anyway, I wouldn't have them in a closed case, I think.
course, if he uses the machine for like gaming or something, maybe. But I would still have the my gaming machine in an open frame if I had like 3 GPUs in it. Of course, if they was water cooled and everything, it would probably be fine, but it seems like they've been in there for a while, so they will probably manage to do a few more rounds on mining. Because it was when I saw the car, I think it was like the fan had like come down to, yeah, you probably see like, and like scratches around on the card underneath it, if I don't remember wrong. That's not good for the fan. Okay, should add some zip ties here maybe, just to make this like more complete. I think I had one yesterday, but everything's a mess around there nowadays. It's like, yeah, stuff all over the place. Yeah, we have this. Yeah, we also have like this. Ah, this is nice. That was fast. Yeah. That's what she said. Not great dinner. What did you have for dinner then? How does this work? That was food. I would actually. Your video make me hungry, man. Okay, so it's actually come out real nice, I think. Ah, we actually have a sticker over here. Kind of. Corsair, but I think it's okay. Ah, I dropped it down on the table.
Oh,
look at this, huh? Almost looks like a factory made machine now. Yeah, it's IKEA. Yeah, this one over here. That's an IKEA, actually, yeah. Yeah, official Corsair mining frame. Probably 12-year-old down in Spain made this or something, I think. Probably. I think the guy bought them on eBay from Spain, I think. He was telling me.
I don't know. How did I put my...
I had... there it is. Okay.
Yeah, change the seat again.
Ah, that wasn't too easy. Ah, I turned off the keyboard. So strange. Ah! Here we are. So... it's actually quite nice frame now, with the white cards and everything. Yeah! Yeah, actually I actually have to get some LED. I think there's RGB on the card. That will light up. I think so. I'm not quite sure. Then we turn RGB just white. If we can do that. So we should probably. Not sure. I have one SSD over here. I think it's Windows on it, but to see if it boots with it. If not, I have to like flash a new one.
Oh yeah.
Wait, be way. Yeah, actually, I didn't have, like, I thought this was just stupid in the beginning. It was like, yeah, why should, because I was smoking. I was smoking like 20, 30 cigarettes a day. And I was like, yeah, why start, like, change it out with something else, like vape or, yeah, you know. No, not for that long. I think I started August last year. Because I was actually quit smoking earlier last year, and I was, yeah, I managed it for maybe 2-3 months, and then I, yeah, then it doesn't work anymore. And I start smoking again, and I, what the hell, I try buy a vape and see if that helps. And it actually, it helps me a lot, because now I, can go like 4 or 5 days in the week, and maybe I buy a package of smoke in the end of the week, and maybe a few days, and then I don't buy smoke for a few days again. So that's at least something. But of course, I really want to quit someday, but just not today, I think. It's not so bad, or kill me. I still do. Yeah, it's not the killing part and the smell, because I didn't smell it too much myself actually, and I'm still alive, so but the most in Norway, it's really expensive. One pack of cigarette costs about, what can we, in dollar we have like, and in USD it's like 15-16 USD for one package of smoke, I think. Cigar, that's nice. I think it's about, probably $16 or something for one package of cigarettes. Yeah, I know, it's really expensive. So it was actually me and my wife, we like putting the numbers together, and we figured out if I smoked about 20 to 30 cigarettes a day, and she maybe 10, 15. So say we smoked about 20 cigarettes a day each. That will be around almost $1,000 in a month, actually. So in Norway, so that's really expensive. It's almost as much as my, like, my mortgage on the house in a month on just smoke. That is actually the biggest reason to quit smoking, and of course my kids. I don't want them to, like, what I said, like, always have to tell them to wait or to go away because I'm smoking and stuff like that. I don't think that's nice. Capital of tobacco product for the US. Yeah. It's actually, we can go to Sweden. That's, of course, I live on the wrong side of the country now, but earlier I was living like, half an hour. And I could go to Sweden and buy cigarettes for, at least half the price. That's in Norway. Oh, as I said, quit smoking. Yeah, I will do it someday, but not just today, I think. It was actually easier than I thought the first time I was trying, and it went actually quite well. And then I got on a party and stuff like that, and things didn't get quite that well anymore. But when I was starting smoking again, after I had quit for two, three, four months, and it was actually really harder to stop again. You guys are all vapes and cigs. I'm all this bad. 20 every day. Yeah. I was poor. I bought cigarettes made on Indian reservation. Yeah. In Norway, you can probably say $150 at least. So, as I said, the vape doesn't cost me too much. I'm not like, I can have this tank for probably a few days or so. So it doesn't cost me much to use it. So then it's better to use that than the smoke. I don't like changing it out with something else. Then I can just smoke, but it's still much cheaper.
Yeah, we tried to get some loaded some Windows on this computer now. I just have to put a screen on it. Let me see if we can take. Probably have to take the screen over that side. Find a cable for it. I don't have to lay on the floor and try finding something. I think I have a HDMI cable over here. Okay, let me see if we just... Yeah, that's actually one more time thing I didn't like about this frame. If you see the I/O on the cards, hello, on the motherboard. We can try with this camera. Don't know many Norwegian stereotypes. No! We are all Vikings, you know. You see the I/O on the motherboard. That's actually a problem, because if you're going to use like the built-in HDMI, it's like, no, that doesn't work. But then you have to like cut it. It was actually annoying. They should have thought about. Yeah, I got really offended.
With chronic like cellulite.
Yeah, yeah. Nice of you to stop by, as always. And you're welcome back. In an hour or so. Yeah, maybe I'm... Let me see, it's 12:30 a.m. now, so... maybe I'm still on, probably. I should go to bed then, but... It's work tomorrow, but... Yeah. We'll see. At least I have to fire this... beauty up. Oh, just have to put this screen over here. See, now we can flash a little on the stream. I hope this, I didn't kill the stream now. Oh, it's okay. We'll try bring the screen over so maybe you can see it. Yeah, always have to keep on building. Then we just have to put the HDMI to the one of the cards, I think. Which one is 16 slot? This one? Over here. Just have to like...
Was it this one? Yeah.
So you sold out of mining. Every card, just had a few more cards now. Technicals. Just a few, yeah. So you sold all the AMD cards also. Let's see if we maybe, I think I have to.
Of course I could like team you into the machine later, but. We just do this for now.
Something about yeah. AMD cards pending sales now. Yeah, it was, as I said, the prices was actually great deals on the cards you were sort of selling. I think this in Norway you can't like. I only got a few great deals the last year, this year, because people trying to get. Too much for them still. And I don't want to pay all too much for the cards. But of course, if you're selling them, you want most out of them, but that's why I'm not selling, I'm just buying.
Hey.
But I can understand it from like, yeah, business point of view. It's like, it's much.
You can't what you call it, like.
You don't make money on it.
So it's, if you have to pay for electricity and you have to pay for the place you have it and everything, like everything, then it's, of course I can understand people selling. Okay, then just the cable for the disc, maybe like put those. You have them somewhere, I think I will.
Yeah.
This one. Yeah, actually, it's like last couple of months I haven't actually did too much on like the coin research side. I just stuck to a few coins that I like, and but I'm kind of like, yeah, what should I say? It's like, I think it's like boring to just mine Ethereum and. And like the big ones, because of course if the price goes up again it's like, yeah, we'll make okay profit I think, but I don't think it will be like crazy amount, like ETH will be worth like $100,000 or something. So of course you would make maybe 120, 150 or yeah, at least on my farm I would probably make, yeah, maybe $100 to $150 each day now if like Ethereum went up to the same price as last year or the year before. But I would of course make my money back on everything and stuff like that. But I like to mine like the more speculative coins, so it has a lot of more potential. So this. Yeah, it's like, I see like this coin Ella is more what you call it. It's like last year it was around $4 I think each coin on all time high. And nowadays I, with my farm, I can mine, yeah, probably a couple of thousand coins each day. So if that coin goes up to just half of what this was worth, like $2, then I will as I say make like $4,000 each day if I mine it now. So looking more at, of course it's, you never know, it can drop to zero as everything, but I think that's like a lame excuse. It's going to drop to zero, I don't think that's going to happen. Of course it can, but I don't think so. I don't hope so. Okay, I was wanting to have like, because I have 2K, two power supplies, and I have like a watt meter, but I can only put one power supply into it. So I was thinking about finding a splitter for the power, so I could plug both PSU in the same. It seems like I have one extra here right now. It's too bad. Yeah, we can't do a lot of stuff. But of course it's 4 cards on each PSU, so just double it almost. We can plug in the one that have the motherboard in the watt meter. Yeah, how many GPUs did you have had on the, when you was like the most, over 100 or around 100? Yeah, at the high 110, yeah. I see, as I said, I have about between, yeah, I think a little over 60. And all of them before, yeah, these GPUs, and a couple of over there, but
But at least 50 GPUs that's mining every day, and all of them are AMD cards. And man, that's been a pain in the ass to like managing them, at least in the beginning. And like over 30 of my cards are on another location. It's not like home in my house. I was driving 20 minutes every time I had to do something with the rigs, and they were stopping, and they was, and it was like, damn. It was not fun. There's a lot of maintenance on them. But of course, after the time, we learned some stuff. Yeah, how you should not overclock your cards and stuff like that, and you kind of getting better to it. So now the rigs are just hashing and hashing and hashing. I haven't actually been down where the three other or the 30 some cards in, I think, probably a few months now. They've been just hashing away. I started having to go to the warehouse if something was wrong. But as I said, now all my rigs down there are stable, and they've been running and running and running without any problems. And I can actually like change the coins on them and the miner on HiveOS without them like going down or everything, anything. Of course, I put like these Wi-Fi adapters on the power for them, so I could like cut the power on them on my mobile phone. Sometimes when I started them again, then it wiped all the power in the building. So then I had to go down there again, and in the middle of the night. And when you come down there and it was late already, and you try to figure out why everything stopped, then you probably was standing there till the morning, and then you have to go to work, and yeah, that's not fun. But for now they are stable, actually. I've been running great a long time now. But I see the latest card that I have down in my own basement now, like 24 cards. I had some issues with that, with at least one of the rigs. Like, yeah, the miner is restarting and stuff like that. I think it was a riser problem from the beginning, so I trenched that out, but it was pain in the ass too. But then it's like suddenly everything works, and now it's just working. So I hope it stays that way. Okay, I think it's ready to fire up now, actually. Yeah. You know, I actually missed one thing. I need extra power for the M.2 slot riser expansion card. So I just have to put that in. Don't know if it needs it, but it's better to just put it. It can't hurt it, at least, I think. We probably like all the power it can get, you know. Okay, just as I say, I really enjoy the fun of like building the stuff and testing out coins and like being part of it. That's almost probably 70-80% why I do it. If it was only to like get a stable income on them and make some money on them, then I could just throw them away, at least for now. It would be crap. Because I don't have a lot of money on them now. Okay, let me see, four of the cards are pulling on. Take the next four. Okay, so should have light on all of them? No, of course we have to push the power button on the motherboard. There we are. Yeah. There it went. Yeah, isn't that like the Acer? Yeah, it restarts one time, yeah. A great attitude about it, man. Thanks for the stream. Heading off to sleep. Yeah. Thank you, man. Thank you for stopping by. Really nice of you. So, hope I see you another time. And, keep up the good stuff. See ya. Okay, it won't start. Why?
some red lights down there. Something's wrong. Just have to figure out what's wrong. Okay, got dozen posts. Just need a little time maybe. Just think what can be wrong. I shouldn't start it up with all the cards right away into Windows. I will probably take out most of disconnect most of the cards first time I start it now. Just to be sure. And we have like the screen connector to the one of the 60 clock GPUs. It should be running. Try starting with only one GPU now. Let's see. Working. Okay. Ah, of course. I have to like put on the right. I have to turn on this one first. It's not power to the motherboard. Then I have to take the next one. And then we can try start it again. See, it's wrong. Yeah, still getting some message. Something's wrong. I think I plugged in everything to the monitor. Yeah. Think. Okay. Do it the easy way then, just think maybe we should unplug this card because it's and then we can power off this power supply for now. Then connect this one to the other 16 slot. Below, I think, yeah, that's one. And that's coming over there into this card. Just have to. Quite sure if that was, yeah, that was the right one. Try power this card because then everything is powered from the same PSU, and not like the card is powered from that PSU and the motherboard is powered. Just see if that makes no any difference. Turn it off again. Should go off now. Yeah, didn't have it. Okay. Let me try start it again. As I said, it should be running because it was running earlier today when I picked it up. Shouldn't be any problems with it. Of course, maybe I fucked up something when I was taking it apart. No, there we have the screen posting. Nice. Okay. Just have to look over here. I think I have to like change around a little there so I can see it sound better myself also. Let me see. Key center setter to recovery by settings after setting up Intel Optane memory. The RAID configuration was built, so the mode selecting was changed in order to avoid unconversion. Ah, yeah, because they had like, I think they had like an M.2 slot, M.2 drive in this machine earlier. So it will probably complain about that. Because they took it out so they could wipe it themselves. And, I will get them later, but window, okay. Advanced. I just think we load the default settings on this one. See what's happening. Okay. Save that and restart it. And in the meantime, I can
pick up some internet cable. Is this long enough? Or do I have to pick up another one, of course? I've got another one over here. Somewhere? Yeah. This is a longer one.
Okay, so it's doing stuff ready. I don't know actually what it's doing right now, but we'll see. It's flashing though. Screen. Okay. Doing okay, so we see if it boots up the Windows now. If not, then I probably have to flash a new disk. No, no problem. You see, just probably have to do like some driver, because I think it's loaded with AMD drivers, this one. Now just have to like take away all the old drivers. I think we should have most of the miners already in this. A lot of them at least. Let me see. Okay, I mean, in the first we do is. Have we. Yeah, DDU. DDU. There we have it. Display driver uninstalled. I don't know if you can see this, but. Could actually, it would probably be better for me if I just remote desktop into this machine, and we can then we can do this together. Updates are available now. Okay, yeah, I think we do that. So then I just going to, I think I have TeamViewer on this one. Maybe, or we just use the. Nah, we just have to use the Windows Remote Desktop, I think. Come on, just have to see if it's enabled. Remote settings. Allow remote connection to this computer, okay. Yeah, I think I've done it before to this computer. I can check it on the main computer if I can get it to talk to it. I think actually I should have a quick launch over here, yeah. You see if that's the right IP. I don't think so, but we can try. Probably not. But that was the IP to one of my laptops I was doing the green wallet on earlier. So we just have to look up the IP address. Let's see. Just so we can connect to it. Network and sharing center. Adapter settings. Status. Properties and TCP/IP. No, we can just do status, of course. Yeah, 1.70. You see, 1.70. Yeah, and of course I have to log in with that password. Nope. Ah. Nope. What was the password? Okay, what we can do then is to yeah, because I'm logged in with my mic. The hell, didn't I remember that? No, I had to change it for not too long ago. So, yeah, so I can't remember my password actually. It's not good. But what we can do is we can make another account maybe. This one is a test rig. Ah, local account. Yeah, that's why. Of course. To try to log into that account instead. We'll probably use another one, yeah. Okay, then we have test rig. Try like no. Yeah. No. Is it this one then? No. This is. I don't use this disk a lot. Okay. Let me just make a new account. You know what? Easiest way. Just load TeamViewer on it. If it's not there. Ah, that's the wrong one. Team. Yeah, we just download TeamViewer. That's more much easier. Right now.
You were looking so hard for wisdom and power. Did you even know it was offered?
And we can soon see it all.
You went looking for a vision the way a hunter chases a buffalo. The way a warrior goes after scalps.
Okay. Let me see. Just give me a few minutes then.
You believe that they
team.
That they owed you a vision. Suffering by itself brings no vision.
Yes. Use team viewer. Do it. Download. Go, go. So, I actually think that I had it on this machine, but suddenly not. How much is the clock? 1 o'clock now in the night. So it will probably just go team viewer on it, test it a little, and then I have to go to bed, I think. Long day tomorrow also. I still have a lot of stuff to go through here, so it will probably be a live stream tomorrow also. Okay. There we have it. It will start up soon. Just have to double check that I actually installed TeamViewer on this machine now. Not actually sure if I have it there now, because I had to reinstall everything not long ago. Team, yeah, I have it. Ah, it installed the NVIDIA driver, I think, yeah. Basic installation, personal use, accept. Ah, yeah, you can see this now, that's not good. No, you can't see that, of course. So, let me see. Okay. Yep. There we are. Okay, then we can just put it into my one. Okay. 8 7 0 2 0 2 16. Then. Yes, there we have it. Now we can see what's happening on this computer. I can still probably use... Yeah, maybe. Yeah, you won't see the... That's not okay. And then we can change this one to over here, I think. Yeah, there we have it. So, yeah. Now we can go to first. I think maybe if I do like this, I can. Yeah, it's okay. Just hide this. I have to hide something else on this machine because it's covering chat. Yeah. Okay. This. Yeah. So first of all, we do the TDU to get rid of the every drivers and stuff on this machine, because it probably have both AMD and Nvidia and everything, and now that's not good. I think maybe I had the 1050 Ti card in this machine on this Windows also. So. Okay, select device. Do GPU, and we take AMD and Nvidia. I think we take away the AMD at least. Clean and restart, clean and shut down, clean and do not restart, and then we take the Nvidia once and then we restart it. See the screen okay? I'm quite sure, but hope so. I want to test this out tomorrow actually. This Soltec card also. See what that can do. Probably have to mess around with the BIOS in this card now, because yeah, the expansion, like the M.2 expansion riser card, probably have to set something up for making that work probably. Let's see, okay, yeah, we can restart to see if it's not. So we just have to restart it. And we'll come back to it. Sultans of Awesome, is it worth GPU mining now? Yeah. That depends. If you have really cheap power costs, it's probably worth it. Of course, for me, I think it's worth it because I do it like a hobby anyway, so I think it's fun to build the machines and maintain them and everything. But of course, if you're thinking all about profit, I wouldn't say it's the most profitable thing to do right now. But of course, it depends on your power costs. But if you're looking a little like further behind or in time, looking about what you can earn, of course, and can be good. I have 7 or 8 old GPUs around. Yeah, of course it depends on the cards. If it's like, yeah, I don't know if it's old AMDs or Nvidia, do they have to be new? No, you can actually mine on quite old cards, but of course they use a lot of power, the old cards, and it's like, as I say, it all depends on the power cost. But of course, if you only have like a few cards, it won't cost you too much each month. So yeah, 780 and 780 TIs. Yeah, maybe some coins are still okay to mine with those. Like Ethereum and that kind of coins is not that good now, at least on the 780s, I think. But if you go for like the newer coins that come out now, like of course more speculative coins, like Grin coin or Beam, or yeah, maybe some Raven coin you can mine with them. And I'm not quite sure, we can, don't know if they actually are listing like 780s on the mining calculators anymore. So probably have to test them and see what hashes you get out of them. Okay, Tinder doesn't. Ah, I have to start it. So, as I say, if you can take the cost and get some coins, of course it can be good. If the price is going up again. Not that I'm like a big trading guy or something like that. I doesn't trade my coins more than I have to. But it's like, if you just hold on to the coins, I think the prices will go up someday. But if they will go up to the crazy amount it was last year, I don't know. You sell your GPUs when you are done. Actually, I haven't sold any of my GPUs, actually. The oldest GPU I have over here now, I think it's an old AMD card. Wait, I still have it, actually. Yeah, this one of my oldest cards. I don't know if you can see it. It's flamey, you see, shiny. It's like an AMD card. It's an HD 2900 Pro, 512 megabytes. So I think this is actually from probably 10, 12 years old, I think, at least. So I still have my cards. but of course I didn't have like 50 and 60 of these cards. I only had one, but I actually tested it on mining a few earlier, or back in the days. I was mining some coins on this HD 5770. And I was actually able to get some out of them, but they use a lot of power. So I didn't actually mind a lot of old Nvidia cards. Mostly I had like AMD cards. A 9800 GX2 and a GTX 295. They would insta die on mine. Yeah, and the problem now is most of the miners that come out now, they won't support the old cards. But of course you can go back and download all the releases of them, and it's like you have just have to test it around and see if anything works with the old cards, but as I say, they will use a lot of more power. So of course, if you had like a gaming machine and have like maybe one or two cards, I would probably put them in mining. Of course, you would pay the power for what you get, but yeah, the Titans see, yeah. And 7000, yeah. Yeah, that's nice cards. As I say, I have like, yeah, I think I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 old cards laying around there now. So, of course, some of them I'd thrown away earlier, back in the days. But for now, I don't sell any of my GPUs. I'm actually buying GPUs now. I just got these 8 cards today. This is 1070 cards. And I got like 3 of the Zotac 1070 cards. They are used, all of them are used. But I got a great deal on them. And, it's when, in the time when the prices are down, that's when you're getting nice deals on the hardware. And of course, when not a lot of people are mining, of course a lot of people still are mining, but it's not like everyone is trying to get into it. And of course, it's not like the big company is trying to make a revolutionary miner every day. So the hardware will actually like last longer now. Of course, if it was a big hype all year, it would probably, big companies would probably put out a lot of ASICs. Probably more ASICs and stuff like that, and it would be harder to mine with GPUs, I think. And of course, people would start stacking up on like 2080 Ti's and stuff like that. That's actually hashing way better, but they're really expensive. So, of course, I wouldn't buy like a 2080 Ti and start mining, or 8 of those to start mining on them. That would be, then I would just buy 1060s or 1070s instead. Yeah, I think I got like about a lot. I got these 11 cards. I got 3 of the Zotac and 8 of these Asus cards. And I got like 4 of these homemade frames, you can see. Got 4 of those with motherboards and PSU power supplies and processors and everything like ready to go. So I think I got about 10 PSU, like most of them is 750 in Corsair and EVGA. And I got 6 of these mining frames, this white one over here that was brand new, and a lot of other stuff, risers and cables and stuff. And I think I paid about in USD, I paid about maybe 3,000, maybe 2,500, 3,000, if I convert it to USD, I think so, around there. So it's not too bad. I paid around 200 for the cards, maybe. That's not bad, not in my country. That's really cheap. So of course, I see you can get them cheaper somewhere else in the US and on eBay and stuff, but then you have to pay the taxes for them and the shipping and everything, so it will probably get more expensive anyway. Just have to connect to the Team Viewer on this machine now. I only like just booted it up. I just built it, and this is the second time I booted it. I just had to take away some old drivers and stuff, because this machine has been running, or this hard drive, this SSD has been running on several test benches and stuff like that. So I just have to unload all the drivers on it, so it doesn't affect it. I just have to move this machine over here. We can see if we can and I just go to GPU and I do the NVIDIA driver also, just clean it so it doesn't. It's not some old drivers there, because I have 1050 Ti in it and yeah, a couple of other cards, so even restart. So let me do that, and then we can start testing it and try. Then we have to load the driver. For now I only have the one card plugged in, so I can load the driver and everything, and then I'm going to plug in the other cards and see if we can boot it up with all the 8 cards. As I said, when I was picking up these cards today, they were standing on one of the other frames, so it was actually, so it was working, so I could check if it was up and going, all the cards working fine, and I've been taken care of actually, so it doesn't, almost doesn't look used at all, so not much dust on them, or they're actually taking care of them, pretty nice. Oh my god, was, I didn't see that before now. Of course, if you want to like mine Ethereum or something, I think I would have bought like AMD cards instead. Of course, it's more work with them, you have to BIOS mod them and everything like that, but if you're comfortable with that, I would I think I would go for AMD cards. You get those even cheaper to this market, but if you like doing stuff like this, and of course it, if you take it as a hobby, and it's okay to do it anyway, I think so. I think it's a hobby, and every hobby costs money, so but this hobby, you actually can make some money on it also, if you think further ahead. That's how it is with everything you spend money on. It's not everything you can actually make money off when you're spending money on it. Okay. Then we should be soon back up running, and then we have to get some drivers installed. So it's actually some RGB on this motherboard here, underneath it. That's nice. Okay, so just like over. I'm back, looks good man, thank you, and welcome back Panda. Yeah, look at those ashes. Ah, that's not this rig, don't stress it. I'm just loading all the, just unloading the old drivers on the OS, and started putting in I have to, yeah, of course. Well, okay, so, and we are back on the machine. Oh no, it looks crap, but you have to put in, have to download latest Nvidia driver now for it. And I have only one card plugged in now, and, so we just can set up the machine, and then we can probably put in the other cards. Let me see. Why did I? Ah, yeah. Of course. I have to go to Nvidia then, maybe. Yeah. I'm not typing Nvidia too often. It's more like AMD. 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 GeForce drivers, I think. I don't like that. I just want to pick them myself. Don't let any program do it. Manually search here. GeForce RTX 20, yeah, I wish. Let me see, 10 series. And we have the from 70. Windows, English, yeah. Yeah, probably. This is what number, Superfire, Beta, no, and we see what's coming up. GeForce, game ready driver. As I say, I'm not really familiar with the drivers and stuff on Nvidia. This is, as I said, the first real Nvidia build I've done. So, I'll probably try to download it and see. Didn't take too much time, I hope. It's 500 gigs, so no megabytes, so yeah, about a minute.
I can do.
So you come home from work now, Panda? Yeah, just got home. So the clock is about 5 or something. 4, 5? 5:30? I'm just trying to figure out what video I'm making for today. Yeah! Yeah, I also should 4:30, yeah. Pacific. Yeah, so it's about 7 hours different time then. I think 6 hours is 10:30. 7 is 11:30, yeah. Yeah, 7 hours. Should be. 7, 8, 9. Yeah, something like that. I'm too tired to start thinking too much about. Yeah, it's 1:26 a.m. now, so it's probably soon bedtime. I should already got been to bed, but I just had to do this today. I was coming home earlier today and picked up all the stuff and just throw it in the room, and it was like, yeah, both the kids was awake and everything. So Birdie, Discord, passion before sleep. Yeah, you know what, Birdie, I have one Discord channel that I should put in. Need help? What do you need help with that I can take up? Yes. Let me see, Discord, yeah, you can just, what help you need, yeah, we're all here to help you, buddy. But, let me see, yeah, I can. If not, you can come into my Discord, or I have like, you can send a link to my, so it's actually like a Norwegian crypto mining Discord I have. It's not a lot of people in there, but I can link it in the chat for you guys. My disk just disappeared from my computer to fast access, can't go into the disk or nothing, it's nothing. Oh, so yeah, not your main disk I assume, but not where you have your Windows, or it's, is it a second disk or? Oh, my 2 terabyte is okay. Yeah, because you have an SSD disk for Windows, and then you have another 2 terabyte for the games and stuff like that. Probably. Of course, I can. The first thing I will do, I can actually show you on this machine now when this is installing. So the first thing I will do, I would go to, let me see, I would right click on this one on my computer, or this PC, or what it's called. Yeah, and go to manage, yeah, exactly, Red Panda. We are thinking the same. Yeah, and then disk management, yeah. As you can see on this computer, you will have, this is my OS, you see, it's an SSD disk of 120 gigabytes. And then you should probably see your other disk, maybe, underneath it. It will come up like, I could probably show you with an USB disk, but yeah, that's in the drawer there, so. But try go in here and see if it shows up. If it doesn't show up on in here, then you're probably fucked. No, but then you have to do it in the BIOS on your machine. To make it show, or like to see if it's still there. See if it's here first, and then you can assign a new letter to it or something like that. I can't promise you that it won't say you have to format it. It's strange if it just disappeared. I have it on my stream if you want to take a look. Okay, yeah, no problem. You can bring up your stream for a few seconds and we can take a look at it. That's no problem. You can... Twitch! Oh, not Twitter, but Twitch.tv. So, some troubleshooting on the way when we're waiting for the drivers to install. That's not too bad. Okay, yeah, I'm not logged in, I'm at 30. Birdy! Slash NO. Go to channel, there we have it. Let me see. Yeah, you have it, but it says unlocated, yeah. That's probably not good. But if you go to, if you like, right click on, yeah, you can see my mouse maybe on, if you see on my screen now, you see on this particular place, if you right click it, where the, you see I'm marking on my screen here, right click this place, yeah, over there, yeah, then you should, yeah, it says you have to put in a new volume, so that's not good, because then you will lose everything you have on the disk, so, because it says, it says it doesn't have any, but you can try go to, no, don't do that. If you don't want to lose everything on your disk, don't do that. Yeah, I think I would unplug the disk in the machine actually and try to plug it in as Red Panda saying in chat over here. But, give me 1 second, I can because if you do the thing you are doing now, then you will format the disk and then you will lose everything on it. The black line part, yeah, there you can probably change. What's this? It seems like Red Panda is trying to help you. No. Okay, so it's a new disc, you don't. Yeah, we'll just bring up, 2 seconds, just want to hear this. Probably have to just put in a headset here for
few seconds.
Said it doesn't have anything on it. Yeah, then it's no problem.
Then you can just make a new partition on it. That's just fine. And you can just call it whatever you want and push next, and it will be fine. And you should have a disk that's fully usable. Nice name. Yeah, and it should, yeah, there you have it, and then it should come up. Yeah, there you have it. Oh, you see. Oh, I have to put this up on my other computer here so I can hear this. Where to go? Let me see. I have too many screens over here now. I'm getting confused. Too many screens and. Yeah, you should follow Birdie Red Panda. He's actually streaming a lot of gameplay. We've been playing together a few times. Fun guy to play with. He's playing a lot of Realm Royale, I think, nowadays. Okay. It's all nice, yeah.
Never mind. Thank you.
Ah, yeah, see, I can see that. This is nice. So, then I go back to the driver install.
And then download,
that.
Okay. Yeah, there we go.
Change, yeah. You can go back and see. I think the NVIDIA driver is installed now. Maybe we have to restart the machine, maybe. Just look it up in GPU-C and see what it says. Here, so you can see it, yeah. It's a micro memory on this DOS card. This is major details. Display settings. Is the driver actually loaded? I'll probably have to. Driver version, yeah, NVIDIA 3.8.8.13. No, that's a bit before 18. I was downloading. Yeah, maybe we have to restart it. I don't know if it actually installed the drivers. I got too excited for helping Birdie. Let's see. Not sure if it actually installed.
so they didn't accept anything. Okay.
System checking.
Last time I was installing drivers for the 1050 Ti, it was a pain in the ass. Because it said, yeah, I got errors all the time when trying to install the driver. How gives me, yeah, at least he got his 2 terabytes back. I was afraid he had yeah, it's all good now. Yeah, I was actually watching the stream on my other screen here. Yeah, I was just afraid he had stuff on it and he was going to like, no, stop, don't do that. But at least it was all good. As I said earlier, I've been playing a lot, yeah, I've actually been playing like Realm Royale with him a couple of times. So, yeah, oh shit. Yeah, me too. Okay, Nvidia graphic drivers and GeForce Experience. That sounds nice. I think we only need a graphic driver though, but we'll do the whole package. Express, nah. Don't usually like that. I don't want it to put stuff on my computer that is I don't want, but it seems okay. Yeah, perform clean install. Yeah, clean install restores all Nvidia settings to the defaults value and remove any profiles you have picked. Yeah. Yeah, it's actually quite fun. I don't think a lot of people are playing it nowadays, but we are actually quite few people. At least, yeah, like Birdie and a couple of other people that's streaming in Norway that I play with. I was playing it a lot before, but I play it sometimes, now and then. Play a lot of PUBG nowadays, of course, but sometimes it's nice to play something else, and then I play Realm Royale a lot. So I was playing it quite a lot when it first came out. I was actually playing it quite much with Son of a Tech. Actually, I was playing a lot of Realm Royale in the beginning with him and a few other guys. So it's actually a cool game. I know you've done a lot of patches and updates on it and changed things back and forth, but it was actually I think they have kind of a good game now. Some of the patches they did was not good. Man, I watch a lot of history. Yeah, me too. I watch a few years back now, I think. I think he's kind of more into the Twitch streaming nowadays. It's not that much content from him, I think, lately. No, he hasn't done much videos. I think he was like, after the big, because he was doing a lot of mining videos, and there was actually great videos. And like, it wasn't like, yeah, the big YouTubers that had every fancy stuff, and it was like right to the case and good explanation of things. And after the mining like hype get over, then I think his videos got like only a few views instead of thousands, and so I think it's like, yeah. But he's streaming a lot on Twitch. I always into his stream when he's streaming and say hello and talk to him. So, nice guy. Yeah, he had quite a lot of good videos on explaining stuff. So see, I follow like, yeah, well, the same with like Basque coin. He also had before, yeah. Of course, if it's, as I see, he's kind of living off the YouTube thing, so he has to like follow the crowd and try to do more like, yeah, maybe like things that not necessarily like to the GPU mining stuff to like survive nowadays. So I can see that. Of course, for me it's not that, like the videos is not like, yeah, I watch them, but it's not that fun anymore, I think. But of course he has to do the right thing for him. So. Of course he had put a lot of stuff to the community the last year, few years. So, but it's sad that you can't like, as I said earlier also, and because I'm, yeah, like my streaming, I could be more active on YouTube maybe to get more followers and stuff like that, but yeah, for me it's like, I think it's as long as it's a few people coming and say hi and in the chat and everything, I think that's more than good enough for me. So say I do this, I would do this if I had a camera or not, but it's more fun with a camera and you can talk to people. As a car channel too, yeah, exactly, yes. I think I have seen a few of the videos on the channel. I don't think I subscribe to the car channel actually, but I think I have a... Yeah, the great thing I like about live streaming is like, you don't have to plan anything, it's just hit a button and it, yeah. You don't have to like edit and think about it and go back and forth and put in music and put in thumbnails and stuff like that. So it's like, yeah, you just do whatever you want. And people doesn't like seeing it, they can just leave, and if they think it's okay, then it's welcome to stay, you know. yeah, I like donating as well. yeah, I share and all that. Yeah, it's like, for me also, it's like, I've been doing a lot of, yeah, I just probably spend many thousands of, yeah, chairs and stuff like that on Twitch, and it's fun, and you get some attention around it, and yeah, and you can interact much more with the creator of the stuff, and that's the funny part. On a YouTube video, if there's, yeah, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, maybe thousands of people, then it's like, yeah, you could just don't live stream, you can just make a video instead, I think. Thank you for the help, man. You and Red Panda, thank you for the 129 biddies. Thank you, Birdie. I should share them with Panda. You should take like 64 and a half of them. Thanks for biddies, and I hope it works out on the computer. My last biddies, yeah. Thank you so much. Stop spamming emotes. You see, the Nightbot gave you a warning there. Okay, Nvidia installer failed. Yeah, that wasn't surprising. Oh, the experience. Yeah, I don't care about the experience. I just want the driver, so... But I think it installed everything else, yeah. Yeah, as I said, fuck the experience. I just want the driver. Restart. Damn you, Nightbot. All game files to this now. Yeah. I do the same. I have like in my main computer, I have my SSD for Windows and yeah, some programs and stuff like that, and I run all my Steam games and stuff like that I put on my hard disk on the side. The download folder and how to move the installer files to your 2TB. Yeah, that's nice. Yes, you can! Welcome to the technical community. We give you an answer to everything. Even things you didn't need to know. Okay, now we're in Windows, we have the NVIDIA drivers installed. Ah, you can see it, damn it, I have to, I don't. That's why I need a capture card, I need to buy one, so I don't need to use this TeamViewer and stuff like that, it'd be much easier. Soon come back to the screen, and we have to buy. No, that wasn't. Okay, then we're back. And it popped up on the wrong screen, of course. Have to move it over there. Yeah, and we can do some stuff. Okay. I'm going to put away this keyboard for now. And I put this on top of. Yeah, right click, game, properties, local files, move, install folder. Yeah. So, Birdie, you are up late today also. I'm going to try putting in a few more cards now. See how that's working out. Oh, we can just test one card on some mining just to see how it, we can use the Phoenix. Ah, we can just to give him some credit. We can use the BBT Multiminer. Can't sleep. Either can I, as you can see. Just doing some crypto mining stuff. You see, I got 8 new 1070 GTX cards today, and a few more around there. Okay, what should we test them on? I want to test them on. We can do CLO. That's a nice coin, I think. I mined a lot of that. It's the Callisto network. I'm deep into that now, I think. Can try and see. I'm not sure if Carter fixed it because it was something wrong with a few of the miners, because I don't think this had a wallet. It seems like it's fixed. Yeah. Okay. Let's see what this can do. Okay. This stock settings, so 26 megahash. That's not too bad actually. So, it's gonna be interesting. And we just pull off afterburner, see what we can get out of it. Yeah, of course it's this Phoenix miner probably. It's Claymore, isn't it? It doesn't auto tune. Isn't this Claymore? Yeah, it's Claymore. Yeah. Oh, we are about 24 mega hash, not 26. And then we are overclocking on the, minus 200 or minus 400. No, plus 600 memory. Okay, let me try that. As I said, NVIDIA is new to me. Just have to I'm going to see on this screen. Power limit, we drop that to 60 to 70, you said, instead of 100. Why down to 70 then? So I have to... Okay, so that was... Of course, I don't have the wattmeter connected to the right power supply right now, so... Now we do the... Core clock to plus... No, minus 2 to 400. Yeah, we try 300 maybe. And then we do the memory plus 500, yeah. Yeah, I don't know. You are the boss now. 500. Yeah, there we got up to 30.3 megahertz right away. Let's see if it can hold it. Well, it seems like it's actually holding it. BBT is getting some CLO from me now, or Callisto network, into his wallet. Boom. Do anything with the core? Nah, no, yeah, that's the same with the AMD cards. You can, of course, a little, but that's not much it does with the core, as you say. Let me see, it seems like it's kind of bouncing a little. Is it stable at 30? On my Zotac 1070 I run it 64 power limit, 200 and 650 on the memory. Yeah. Yeah, but you see it bounces up and down now, down to 25. So, but it, I haven't done any settings on the BIOS, and I have no, I think, yeah, the virtual memory shouldn't have too much to say when you're only running one card, so but you see it bounces up and down. All over, yeah. Can I move the whole Steam file over to the new disk without getting problems with my Steam? Yeah, I should be able to do that. Like, I have all my games on the other disk, and if I do a clean install of Windows, I just go into my Steam and just select the folder, and then it will automatically load it back into the Steam account. It will ask, yeah. It will ask where you want to save it, yeah. So this is bouncing up and down. We can try maybe see if it helps to put it down some more, down to maybe 400 just to see, and maybe just put up the power some 80 maybe, just to like don't give it too much in the beginning, see if it's more stable then. If it's still bouncing up and down, and I think we have to do some BIOS, maybe the Gen in the BIOS or something is wrong. The Steam file in program files. Yeah, I think it will only move. Yeah, no, the Steam file will still be there because I think that's only the program folder. I think it saves the game another place on your. Maybe I'm wrong. Because I think it saves the game files like default in like local and app data or something. Okay, 29, 27, 29. It seems like it's still bouncing up and down maybe. But man, this card is like, you can't almost, it's running like, just idling. This was an AMD card, it was like rev up a long time ago. Probably had like 72 Celsius now. Yeah, it seems like it's holding 29.5 almost. It has created a folder named Steam Library in the 2TB disk. Yes, it is. The fan not even going. Yeah, I know. It's like the fan is going on not many hard at all. 39%, that's not too bad. Of course it's kind of cold in this room now. I have the window, actually a little bit open because it was really hot in there. Seems like it's stable on 29 now. We can maybe try putting the memory up to 500 again. Maybe it was because of the power limit that it was starting bouncing around. Or maybe it wasn't going to take 500. See, maybe we should. It's up to 30 again, see if it's holding that or if it's going up and down. It seems might holding 30. 30.4. 30.42, yeah. I haven't like tested a lot of seen a lot of benchmarks on this Nvidia cards, so now they're way down to 15, so doesn't hold that very stable. Maybe 450 then. Can take this down, try just going down to 200 and no, not plus 200 but minus 200 instead. See, we are 30 now. Of course, as I say, I don't think I'm going to run these cards on Etash anyway. I think I'm going to put them on Grin or Beam or Suka or Raven Coin. I'm not sure yet. It's running. No, it's bouncing up and down. Did we just go back to the stock settings? I actually think it was bouncing a little bit in the beginning also when we had it at stock settings. Maybe it's some BIOS issues. I'm not sure. Because it started on 26 and then it went down to 24 and 26, yeah. I think it's some other problem, something else causing the problem maybe. I think I have to go to the BIOS and set up some stuff in there. Yeah, 26.4. Fluctuation, yeah. Seems maybe more stable now after I... yeah, Gem, I'm not sure, I haven't checked the BIOS actually. Yeah, I think it should be at Gen... yeah, probably 1 or 2. Yeah, and for G decoding, of course. Yeah, you see it bouncing up and down, so I think we can just kill it and go to the BIOS settings, because I loaded the default settings the first time I booted this machine earlier today. No, earlier. But shut it down, and I think I'm going to try plug in some more cards when we started again. Did you do it? Yeah, the virtual memory should be already done in this. I don't think it should have too much to say when you're only running one card, but of course when you're running more cards it should start to have an effect. So just go to the BIOS, let me see. Maybe I can try put down one of the cameras and see what I'm doing. I think we just switch to this screen again. I can just pull this camera over, see if I find a good spot for it. Probably put it on this box over there. Yeah. Can see it now, I think. Just have to remove something on my screens. Let's see the way. Yeah, you can see it now. I have too much stuff everywhere. So if we put this over there, I put this
way further back. Yeah, like this. That's nice. Okay, so then we go to advanced mode. And we go to the advanced here. And we go to platform. No, not platform. Yeah, this is disable everything. That's good. And then we go to graphic. Okay. Yeah, it's set to auto and it's Gen 3, yeah. I think we put it on Gen 2, I think. Game capture, camera in front of the screen. Yeah, no, I need a capture card. Then we go to this one and we put that to Gen 2. Put that to Gen 2. Okay. Back. And, shouldn't it be where was the 4G encoding? And we also have this one we can set to Gen 2. Storage. Of course, I have to turn off a lot of other stuff in this BIOS later, but for now, I think I just don't. Of course, you can turn off like internal everything like audio and stuff like that, but I do that later. But where is the 4G encoding? This is a little different from the B250 BIOS on the Asus card. Native management. I think everything of this should be enabled. I think the 4G encoding should be in here, but I don't find it. Because before, I think it was. I think it was on the top, like here should be. Graphics, yeah, I was into graphical, but wasn't there. But I also don't know what BIOS version this card's working on, so maybe we should check the BIOS and maybe do a BIOS update on it before we do anything. So we just do the flash, and we are the internet. So I just do a BIOS update on it, and then we can come back and see it. They probably didn't do any BIOS updates on this motherboard. But as I said, these 8 cards and this motherboard has been working together on mining, so they probably got it working anyway. HCP. Whoa, there. Do you want to download the latest BIOS file? Yes, download it. Yeah, 1302, yeah, this is. What was it? I didn't see the. Yeah, probably an old one. Okay, and we're flashing the BIOS. Let me see. Yeah, 09.2, yeah. Yeah, that's probably the stock BIOS on it almost. That's what I love about the Asus card, that you can. Probably the other cards have come with it also, but that you can. Flash it via internet in the BIOS, that's really good. Yeah, enjoy the dinner. I'm probably going to bed soon, so otherwise good night. Yeah, if I'm still here, you're welcome back, of course. If I'm not here, I will see you later, talk with you later, man. Really nice for you to stop by, and I hope you get some good videos today out.
Yeah, of course. I will probably have a stream tomorrow also. I have a lot of more to go through here, so this is just the top of the iceberg, or what you call it. Yeah, thank you. I actually like this build. I like the white theme. The surprisingly white theme. Yeah, see you tomorrow then. Bye bye.
Up.
Yeah, white theme beast. Fill up my way. So, then we just have to wait for the BIOS to update, and we can see if we can enable 4G encoding. And I'm not sure if we have to do any settings for the PCI, like the expansion card on the M2 slot, or if it just enables it right away. I'm not sure. So, time will show. Time will show. Oh, this feels like an old setup when I have the camera on the screen. It's like the good old days, as you said, Birdie, earlier. Can capture air. Okay, so it should reboot. And we can see what's new in the BIOS now. Probably done some different stuff. Yeah, I was thinking about, yeah, one question, of course. Hit me. You can have two questions if you want also. Okay, so it's going to like a loop now. And there's something flashing down there, and it's turning on and off. You see, I was doing that the first time I was booting this motherboard also. Seems like it's, yeah, there is posting. Then we should probably get into the pCenter setup to recovery settings. The new device has been detected in the, yeah, PCI bandwidth on M2 socket can be set to 2 or 4 default. X2 configuration shares bandwidth with the SATA 5.6 ports. Okay, where did I put the damn hard disk? SATA 1, 2. Oh, so I put it. Okay, so I should probably put the hard disk, no, the SSD on the 1. Change the RAID mode to avoid unknown issues. Okay. Ah, let me just fire it up and see what is. Can I move all content in common in Steam apps into the new hard disk and delete it? In the old disk. Yeah, you shouldn't be any problems to delete it on the old disk if you have already moved everything over to the new disk. As I said, I don't remember where it like stores the game files from the beginning or when you have it on the main disk, but if you moved it over, it should be fine. As long as you moved everything, you can always go back in Steam and tell it to pick up the game files in the correct folder if it's Alexa Bees, welcome to the stream and thank you for the follow. Okay, thank you. Yeah, no problem. Always here to help, you know. Let me see. So then we can check some BIOS settings before we go boot it up again. Still no 4G encoding. Yeah.
range. Okay, it's auto, let's put it to Gen 2. I think we're going Gen 2 on them. I think that should be okay. This is no. Okay. And we have no 4G encoding in here, no. PCI Express configuration, Gen 2. This is, yeah, here we have some of the for the SEDA. As I said, we have this expansion card on one of the cards in here, so should be Thunderbolt is disabled on board devices. Yeah, we can disable this one. TV port audio disabled. M21 configuration set to auto. Bandwidth to 2x2. Yeah, we just leave it for now and come back to that later if it's causing any problems. Power off, we take power on. If you miss the power, you can just, then it will power on again. That's USB configurations. As I said, the 4G encoding, I can't find the 4G encoding on this BIOS. Was strange. Should be there somewhere. I thought it was under under the advanced and not platform but system and graphic configuration, or it should just be like here. But, yeah, we just try start it up again and see if it's doing better now. Nothing, no, that's just monitoring. Let's boot. Yeah, there we have it, 4G decoding. Yeah, enabled. Yeah, now we can save, exit. We can see. We still only have one card plugged into the machine now, and we're just testing it on just to see if it's holding stable and just doesn't go like bouncing up and down on the hash rates. Now we can probably go over to the team viewer again. So then I just move this camera up over here. A look at this nice machine instead. I'm going to pick up the team viewer. Cannot. Okay. So just a few seconds, and I'm bringing back the team viewer on the machine so we can all see what's happening. It's time to connect to it. I have to start it on this machine maybe. That helps. Okay, let me try one more time. And there we are. Password, and there we should be up and running. I have to move it to the other screen, and I have to let you guys see it. So we have to do like this. Here we are. Yeah, that will probably. Sometimes it's actually like a relief to just format all your disks and just reinstall everything and start from scratch. It's like cleaning your soul sometimes. I do that
couple of times a year on my main computer. Just format everything and start from the beginning. Of course. Sometimes it's like getting a lot of stuff on it. Okay, then we see me dragging up the. Just put it down there so you can see it. I'm going to use the GPU-C later, but just want to see that they holding the hashes stable for with no overclocks and everything on anything. Yeah, if you're going the easy way to do it in when you have Windows 10, you can do like probably you have like a pre-installed machine when you got it, so then you can just go to in some cases you can boot up from a recovery disk you have on like a hidden disk that you can boot up from. Or you can just go to, I think you go to Windows and Settings and something like Recovery or something like that, and you can do like clean everything and reinstall Windows and it will boot up and just do it for you. But sometimes then it will create an like Windows old file folder on your C disk that contains a lot of the old files, then you have to delete that. But then you also have to open up the permissions to delete like system files and stuff like that. But it's, if you Google it, you will probably find a lot of ways to do it, like easy ways. Oh, 3 hours now. Yeah, it's probably time to go to bed soon. Let me see, 26.5. So it's holding quite well now. Not bouncing to 24 and 26 and 24 again like it did earlier, so we can maybe try overclocking it a little and see what it's doing then. Taking up MSI Afterburner, then we can try like 500 on the clock and load on the memory. I think we just try 500 on the memory first and then we test like with the power and stuff later. So there we are up to 30.3. Let's see if it's holding that now and doesn't do crazy stuff. Oh, yeah, there we see it drops down to 26 again. And then it's probably up to 30 again, yeah. Maybe I gave it a little too much, but maybe it's holding. Yeah, it seems like it's stable now. No, oh, there it's down again. So we have some more work to do on the BIOS, I think. Maybe we can try 400 just to be sure. I actually think I have to go to bed now. It's 2:30 a.m. now, so it's probably coming back to this tomorrow and doing some BIOS stuff on it and see what we can get out of it then. Of course I can check the virtual memory just to be sure, but I think it should be okay. And with one card you shouldn't actually have any problems with that, I think. Advanced. advanced. Yeah, withdraw memory settings, advanced, yeah, there we have it. Yeah, 24, so it should be more than enough. See, it's bouncing up and down everywhere, so that's good. Can of course try something else just to be sure. Can try. Yeah. Where is all the fun stuff in there now? Yeah, this is the version 8. Yeah, it's not the latest one, of course. I think he made a version 9 beta or something, so we should probably download that instead. Yeah, we can try Ravencoin, just to see. T-Rex miner, always. Hello. Yeah, it starts nagging about its virus in the miner and stuff. Oh, it probably killed it now. Ah, there we see, 12.14 megahashes. That's not too bad. I don't know what the settings are on the intensity 20. Yeah, you're right. Yeah, it killed it because of the virus threads. As I said, it's not stable now, but I think I come back to this rig and continue on it tomorrow. And getting all the cards working. And thanks for sticking by, for all the people that's been in the chat and saying hello. And thank you for the followers, the new followers. Welcome to the mining family. And yeah, Birdie, thanks for stopping by. Hope your computer is okay. And see you next time. And thank you for the biddies. You're number one, the bit leader now. That's nice. Yes, see you all. Good night. Take care. Bye bye.